Hi, from Fire Chemistry, Chapter 2, this is your video number 18 and your notes page number 21. Okay, so now we almost finished everything about alkene and alkenes, but why not we go to the past here? Very sorry, we cannot go any past here because we not 100% complete the title for alkene, alkene and others. And in the past year, normally they ask together, 一起来咯, 所以不能做什么? So before we proceed to the next homologous series, alcohol, we still having a very big title. And this title will be at the end of your textbook, 在你的 textbook 的最后面, by move in front. I need it now, 我现在要用到, okay? So our title will be isomerisms. So what is mean by structure isomerisms? For isomer in Chinese, we call 异构体, 不一样结构的, 个体, okay? 不一样结构的个体, but not understandable, 新的, okay? Not difficult, but a lot feel very difficult. I don't know why, 我也不知道为什么, 不过不难就对了, 跟你讲, 很爽的。 Structure isomerism is a phenomenon where a compound has the same molecular formula, but with two or more different structure formulas. So 什么叫 isomerism? Compound with the same molecular formula, but different structure formulas. 这些化学物品呢, 它们有一样的 molecular formula, 不过它们有不一样的 structure formula. 它们有一样的名字, CS单, 不过它们有不一样的外表, 有的 CS单 endowed, 有的 CS单 没有, 这种就叫 isomerisms, 异构体, 名字一样, 不过结构却不一样. So write a sentence, 写一句话, okay? Write a sentence, 写好好。 What is mean by isomerism? 什么叫 isomerism? Okay, like. So isomer, they are molecules that have the same molecular formula. 某某化学物品, 化学分子. They're having the same molecular formula, but different structure formula. 不过它的结构不一样. Chemical formula 一样, 不过结构却不一样. But any example, 什么 example? So, you turn to page number 22, 你转去下面, page number 22, I show you the example of isomer, 异构体. Okay, so any example, 什么例子呢? I, page number 22. Okay, isomer of pentane, still remember pentane's alkane 的第五个成员, 对不对? C5H12. So C5H12, this is the pentane, 对不对? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 加12粒的 hydrogen, so this is pentane. But do you know, pentane actually having other structure? Pentane 其实还有另外一种结构. Okay, now it look like this. C5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. H12, 它也是12. So this is pentane, this is also pentane. C5H12. Pentane and pentanes, they're having the same molecular formula. 它们有一样的 molecular formula, C5H12, but different structure. 不过它的结构却不一样, 对不对? 啊, 这种就是我们所谓的 isomer 异构体, isomer. Same molecular formula, but different structure formula. Okay, so draw on your page number 22, 把这个新图片画在你的第22面, 我等一下要用到。 Okay, 我一边教, 一边给你看 example, I need it, 我需要, 我要, 用到。 So C5H12, 原来地球上有超过一种的 C5H12。 So 这种情况叫异构体, 这种情况也叫 isomerism, 异构体出现了, 对不对? 不一样的结构的人出现了, 明白吗? Okay, next. 再来, turn back to your page number 21, 再回去你的第21面, 我们再讲更清楚一点点 about isomerisms, 异构体。 Structure isomerism can occur in several ways. Okay, 异构体呢, 有几种情况会出现。 Okay, the first one we call chain isomerism, 就是那个 formula, 那个 molecule 的 chains, 那个碳的链呢, 有不一样的情况出现。 So chain isomerism 就是那个碳的链, 那一条碳, 还记得吗? C5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 有没有? So chain isomerism, what's mean by chain isomerisms? The isomer have the different arrangement of carbon chains. 那个 isomer 那个 molecule 里面的碳的链呢有不一样的排法。So isomer have different arrangement of carbon chains, 它的碳的链排的不一样。Either straight chains or branch chains, 可能是 straight chains 直链。Or maybe branch chains, 可能有一条链不过它有分叉出来。So straight chains or branch chains, OK, 不知道。Can't imagine, 想象不出 Never mind, I show you the example and we draw slowly. 什么叫异构体？ So, 第一种异构体 okay, that we call chain isomerism, 就是那条链出现不一样，造成结构不一样了。So any example, 讲都没有用。Example make you understand, not me, 不是我。Okay? So chain isomerisms, 它的碳的链呢，出现不一样的排法。So this is butane. How I know butane? C for H10, CN, H2N plus 2, 一看就知道它是 alkane, 对不对? Butane, 四氯碳的 alkane. Okay, the first isomer of butane, 它的第一个结构就是直直的一条链。So 1, 2, 3, 4, 四氯碳排成一条直链，对不对? Draw. Straight chains, 所以这种就是一条直链啊。So 有些人穿链，它的链就是一条单调。有些人穿链，它是一条链，然后链的旁边加了很多的 side chains, branch chains, 对不对？旁边的 chains 也是很美了，随便了，只要那个人美，怎样穿都美。不美的穿会更美。OK, 好呢。So straight chains, carbon atom arranged into a straight chains, 它排成了一条直链。And another one, 另外一种呢 ，it will be branch chains. OK, 那。Four carbon atom, one, two, three become a straight chains. 这三粒碳呢排成一条直链。By another carbon become the side chains or branch chains. 不过另外一粒碳却排成了另外一个 branch chains, 它的分叉，对不对？所以它没有直，它直过后它有一个分叉点，对不对？所以这种叫 branch chains. So chains isomerisms is just because of the arrangement of the carbon atom in the chains become different.碳的排法不一样，造成它的链不一样，明白吗？所以这种 straight chain 直链，所以 straight chain straight chains。之前我们读 alkane 的时候啊，我们在画它们的时候，我们一直有强调 straight chain straight chains。And I just tell you simple, that means simple alkane 啊，简单的 alkane, 简单的 alkane 啊。那这种最简单一条直链，这种有 side chains branch chains 的呢？也不是很难啊，它只是多了一个 side chains. So this is what we call isomer or chain isomerism. 它的链，它的碳的排法不一样而造成的异构体。Okay? Or beside the chain isomerism, 还有什么 isomerism? 还有什么情况会出现 isomer 呢？ Position isomerism, position isomerisms, 位置的不一样也造成了那个结构不一样，什么意思？The isomer have the different position of functional group on the carbon chains. 那个异构体 have the different position of the functional group on the same carbon chains. 在同样的碳的链上面呢，它的 functional group, still remember functional group, 还记得这一句话吗？ Functional group, 就是造成那个 molecule 有它的化学特征的那一团东西，对不对？ Functional group.So isomer 出现不一样的结构，就是因为那个 functional group 的位置不一样，它躲在不一样的地方。Okay, but not understand. Without example, 怎么能明白呢？对不对 ？So position isomerisms because of the position of the functional group. Functional group mean the structure of the molecule that cause chemical properties, 造成它的化学特征的那一组东西了，那一团东西。OK, 什么意思 ?Don't know. 来 ,position isomerisms, OK, butene, 这个叫 butene, OK, 什么叫 butene? So the normal butene, OK, not normal 啦，其实全部的 butene 都 normal 啦 OK, so alkene, the functional group will be double bond between the two carbon atoms, 对不对 ?OK, so for the first isomer of butene 的第一个结构就是The double bond on the first carbon atom, 它的 double bond 呢粘在第一粒跟第二粒的碳之间，对不对？所以我们算它是第一粒了，我们用小的 number, 不要算它第二粒，用小的 number. So the double bond on the first carbon atoms. So 它的位置就在第一粒碳那边。But another butene, 另外一种 butene 呢，就是它的异构体，它的结构看起来一模一样 ，but the position of that functional group is different. 不过它的 functional group 的位置啊，完全不一样。So another butene, 另外一个 butene 呢 ，double bond on the second carbon atom, 它的 double bond 躲在第二粒碳的那边，第二跟第三啊，一二三。So 一二和三，我们算二了，明白吗 ？So double bond on the second carbon atom.So, 这种叫 position isomerisms, the position of the functional group and cause a difference in structure, 造成结构不一样，这种情况就叫 position isomerisms, 明白了没有 ？OK, so isomer 出现可能就是因为它的 chains, 它的链 strict chain side chains, 要不然就是 position, the position of the functional group, 可能在第一粒碳，可能在第二粒碳，就造成了各种各样的结构了 ，OK。来 but somebody they start to ask, okay, 这个 butene 跟这个 butene, is it the same? 它们是一样的吗 Okay, they having the same properties or not? 它们的化学特征一样吗 Or physical properties 有一样吗 Okay, or another example, 刚才的 example, this is a butene, 对不对？这两个都叫 butene.But do they having the same properties, chemical properties or physical properties? 有一样吗？不知道，对不对 ？Okay, now I tell you the answer 啦。现在我告诉你答案。Diisomer show same chemical properties. 不管你的结构是怎样的 ，you still in the same homologous series. 你还是来自同样的一个家族。So you still having the same functional group. 你还是有一模一样的 functional group.Another meaning, isomer actually they show the same chemical properties, 因为 functional group 一样，明白吗？同样的家族 ，so 它的 chemical properties 其实没有变。不管什么 butene 哪一类的结构的 butene, the chemical properties still the same, 保持不变。So isomer show the same chemical properties because each isomer has the same functional group.因为每一个 isomer 都有自己的 functional groups， 那个 functional group 决定了它的化学特征。因为 same homologous series， same functional group， same chemical properties， even the structure different。你要买那个不用紧。OK， about physical properties， physical properties 有一样吗？ Different， 绝对不一样。OK， 怎样不一样？ OK。If the isomer having more branches, 如果那个 isomer 有比较多的 branches, 里面它的长链不够长，那它的链呢变成很多的 branch chains 啊。OK, for this type of isomer, 它旁边的 side chain 多多 ,branch chains 多多的 isomer, normally, they having lower melting point, boiling point, 它们的熔点沸点呢会比较低的，比较容易被解开的，明白吗 ?OK? So the physical properties like melting point, boiling point are different, 不一样。The more branches there are, the lower the melting point and boiling points. So 长长的链、啊、那一种它的熔点沸点比较高。如果它那条链有很多 chain chains, side chains, branch chains, 它熔点沸点呢会比较低。所、so, 以这种就是 isomerisms. Okay, physical properties difference. Physical properties difference. Okay.Another sentence that is very, very important also, 也是很重要 but I don't ask you to copy 啦，因为我怕你手酸，你手酸我心痛的其实、嗯、来下一句话也是很重要 Generally, the number of isomer of a molecule increase with the increase of the number of carbon atom in the molecule. OK, highlight first and I tell the meaning 啦，我告诉你它的意思 Generally, OK,The number of isomer of a molecule increase with the number of carbon atom in the molecule. I translate to Chinese. 如果那种分子啊，它的碳越多，它可以形成的异构体呢就更多，对不对？有那个分子越大，它的碳越多，它可以排出来的不一样的结构呢就会肯定比较多。为什么呢？碳多容易乱排嘛，千变万化，对不对 ？OK。So butanes, 你可能排成一条直链，可能有一个 side chains, 可能有很多 chains. But pentane hexane, 因为它的碳更多，你可以排出更多更多不一样的结构。But now, I'm not convinced to talk about this. Okay, because we still having a lot of example to make you understand the sentence. 这一句话等一下要靠 example 来了解。汗液多，你能画出来的结构啊，更多，千变万化，明白吗？ Okay, so 这种就叫 isomer。Any problem? 有什么问题吗？没有啊。Okay, if no problem, we're going to draw isomer and call their name. 如果没有问题呢，我们就会开始教你画 isomer。然后教你称呼他们的名字 because different isomer actually they're having different name 当结构不一样那条链就不一样的那条链的名字就不一样了对不对 so we temporarily stop here 要不然就太长了你听了好像很累对不对 OK see you in another video thank you